Welcome back to the Mama Script. I'm Lucy, and if you haven't met me, I'm really stoked that you're here. I hope that you have watched our previous videos and like what you see, and also are enjoying our community. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. We appreciate you more than you know. I thought that I would quickly jump on in the midst of today's video just to have a quick little chat with you, and then also at the end I've got some tips and recipes and food ideas to share with you, so make sure you stay all the way to the end. So before we jump into today's video, I just thought I would do a really quick chit chat about Jamie, who was my partner in the Mama Script, who is also my best friend and my sister-in-law. We have a very unique relationship. If you've watched our original video, you'll know a bit about that, so I'll link that down below. You can go and check that out. But as some of you may have known throughout the time that we've been doing the Mama Script, it hasn't been a year yet. It's been about 6 months now, I think. But Jamie has gotten extremely busy in her job at Australian Sports Nutrition, and I 100% support her in that. I'm sure everybody as mums can appreciate that, you know, our time is spread so thin at the best of times. So to have a very sort of demanding job and also try and be building something on the side and being a mum and a partner and everything else is really challenging, and it definitely was something that Jamie felt she wasn't able to juggle or didn't want to sacrifice her family time and things like that. So of course, being her best friend and her greatest, you know, fan, I would never want anything to hinder her. So she has decided to step out of the Mama Script, but being my best friend and being my sister-in-law, I do see her a lot. You will see her in content and videos, and we'll do a couple of videos together sporadically every so often so that you can catch up with her and see how she's going. But for now, you are stuck with me. So hopefully you enjoy the content that I bring you. Lots more new stuff coming your way soon. As always, I'm so open to your suggestions and your ideas for topics, things that you want to see. I do ask a lot of questions like that on Insta stories, so if you're not following us on Instagram, I'll pop our little Instagram tag up there so that you can follow along. But yeah, so very excited for the future, and yeah, anyway, let's jump into today's video. So today's video is a vlog. We had some good feedback about the first one. I'm really stoked that you guys enjoyed it. I am brand new on the vlogging scene, so I do not have a fancy vlogging camera or fancy lights or a cameraman following me around, so please excuse, you know, little things that show that, but I really enjoy doing it. I'm enjoying the editing process, so yeah, be gracious to me, but I really hope you enjoy it because I'm enjoying making the content for you. Today's vlog is a little bit different. We've done a day, I keep saying we, I've done a day on the plate. So I've shared everything that myself and my daughter Sophie has eaten throughout the day, but she's 14 months at the moment. So she's in an age where she is eating all the time. She's always been like a grazer. She eats all day. So it's sort of good to be able to share that with you. This day that I actually did vlog ended up being such a busy day, and we were actually out a lot, so I didn't really get to make as many meals as I usually do at home and snacks and things like that. So I am gonna jump on at the end of the vlog and share a few lunch recipes and lunch ideas with you, because I wasn't able to do that in the vlog. So I'll leave you to it for now. I really hope you've grabbed a cuppa or a glass of wine and sit down and enjoy this vlog. And I'll speak to you at the end. Happy Thursday. I thought I would do a vlog today. I'm actually gonna do a day in the life slash what's on my plate. So I'm gonna share with you, yeah, what food I eat in a day. So a few people have been asking for some lunch recipes and just sort of like on the go food that is easy to make and doesn't take too much time and things like that. So I thought I would share that with you today. So let's get into it. Thank you.
Good morning. So I was up at 5 o'clock this morning. She's growling at my mug. I start every morning with a hot lemon water. So as you would have seen, I half fill it with boiling water and the rest with filtered room temperature water. There's so many benefits to lemon water, so I encourage you to do your own research, but a few things it does is kickstart your metabolism for the day. It's good at ridding toxins in your body, really, really good for your skin, like the health of your skin, the brightness of your skin, detoxifying your body. So yeah, definitely if it's not something that you do and you're wanting to add in some healthy habits to your lifestyle, I definitely think a warm lemon water at the start of the day is a great idea. And if you're ever feeling bloated or, you know, feeling like something that you ate throughout the day has sort of not made you feel very good, then a hot lemon water can really help that. So, yes, I absolutely swear by it. So Sophie and I are about to go and get ready. Well, actually, Sophie stays in her pajamas, but I'm going to go put some active wear on and we are going to go for our walk. So another thing that I swear by every morning that makes my... Oh! What's wrong? Another thing that I swear by is walking every morning. It just makes me feel good. It's so good to get outside. And yeah, I really feel like if I miss my walk in the morning, if it's raining or I've got something on early or something like that, I do, yeah, really feel like my day is just a bit disjointed and just don't feel as good. Obviously, you get endorphins from exercise and endorphins make you happy. And they release good chemicals throughout your body for the day. So to me, it's a bit of a stress relief and just gets my body moving. And I love being outside. And Soph loves our walks. I've done this pretty much since she was a newborn. I felt like in the early days, here's another vlog tangent. I felt like in the early days with Soph, I'll have to jump on and tell you guys my story, but I really struggled to get out of the house within the first 3 to 4 months of her life. We had so many struggles with different areas of the whole journey, which I'm sure everybody does, but I was also experiencing a lot of trauma, post-trauma from her birth. So I felt like my walk every morning was my chance to just clear my mind. She was so peaceful in the pram walking around, which she wasn't at home, so it was sort of like our break, I guess. But yeah, so love my walk, so we're gonna go do that now. Might give you a little bit of a sneak peek at our beautiful complex that we live in. We're really lucky, so the complex we live in has this beautiful little lake and there's ducks and things like that, so when we go for our walk it's a really beautiful scenic walk. So yeah, we'll see you back there. I would share because I am consuming something. Sophie, give it to me. Water! Yes, you can have it back now. She's obsessed with it. But it is super important, as you would know, to drink as much water as we possibly can. So I usually aim for 1 to 2 liters a day, which probably doesn't sound like very much. But for me, it's a lot. Because I have a very weak bladder, so anything more than that and I just cannot function throughout the day. But I do try and drink more if I've exercised. So it's a liter to every 30 minutes of exercise. So, that's a lot. So I usually do about 500 mils for every 30 minutes. So adding that on definitely makes a difference to the amount of times I go to the toilet. But it is really, really important. But considering this is not on my plate, but it is something I'm consuming, I thought I would share it with you. And a really good tip to make sure that you're having as much water as you possibly can, especially I find days when I'm at home, I don't know if anyone else is like this, but I don't drink enough water on the days when I'm at home because I just don't think to pick it up. So I carry this around with me into every room I go into, whatever I'm doing, and it just reminds me to keep drinking my water. I really find that it helps. So definitely don't drink as much on my home days, but at least this makes me drink something. So we're just about to head out for a meeting. Can't say what it's about, but I'm hoping to be sharing that with you very, very soon. So we're going to go and do that, and then I'm going to race back and give this little one a sleep because being up at 5 o'clock does not sit well with her. So yeah, go for a little bit of a play. Where we're having the meeting is somewhere where she can play a little bit. So and there's another bubby that will be there too. So she's going to do that.
So I've decided to make some brekkie before I go out. Save some money rather than buying it at the cafe, and then I know I can eat everything that I've got. So I'm going to have some smoked salmon. I slightly cook this in the pan purely because I don't like the texture. One egg, Nutellex made with coconut oil. This stuff's amazing, and I have it on gluten-free whole grain toast. Cook up some tomatoes. I always like to get the medley because it's just more colour. And some snow pea sprouts. I usually have spinach on top, underneath, and then these on top, but run out of spinach. And then I have some salt and pepper for on my eggs. I love paprika, so I have that on my eggs and on my tomatoes and on my salmon. And I cook it all in this liquid coconut oil. Amazing. So I'll show you when it's done. Here is my breakfast. There's no clean, chef's plate or anything, but I've got a really good balanced meal here, so carbs in my bread, got good healthy fats, omega-3s in the smoked salmon, protein in the egg, again good fats, a little bit of green, and yeah, absolutely delicious. So now I'm going to eat and enjoy. So we are just at a cafe, so she's having some fruit at the moment, she's having some blueberries and grapes. But I thought I would just share that she just had this, so I get these for on the run. They're just so much easier than trying to keep the homemade food cold and things like that. So it's certified organic, it's apple, pear and cinnamon. And again, you know me, looking at the ingredients and trying to get it in the sun so you can see. But it is just apple, pear, cinnamon, that's it. How amazing are those ingredients? And these are so cheap, they're from Aldi, so we've got an Aldi menu, these are good. So even though this is a good product, this particular brand has other flavors that have additives. So don't just think, okay, awesome, this brand's really good, because not all their products are this good. So this one's amazing, and there's also two other flavors. So their fruit ones are good, but I don't buy their meat or veggie ones because they do have additives. So just something to remember. And then I also made Sophie some homemade pear puree, which she just had as well, so that's what's on her plate for brekkie. So I am now having a chai. Usually I have it on coconut milk because I don't have dairy, but they only had almond or soy, which I can't have on my low FODMAP diet. So today is lactose free milk, so hopefully it doesn't make me sick, but it's delicious. And my mysterious friend that I'm here with for my meeting has some coffee, so that's what's on our plate. And I made breakfast like you would have seen before I came to save some money. So
hello everybody, so I'm finally looking a bit more presentable than I was this morning. I've had a shower, clearly haven't washed my hair. Washing day, look at all of that, kill me now. On my sort of last day that my hair's dirty and I need to wash it, I do this style because I just put hairspray in it and it's just like a wavy mess, but I like it. So Sophie's asleep. She's been asleep for nearly 2 hours, which is amazing. She went down half an hour later than she usually does because I'm transitioning her to one sleep a day. So just every day pushing it back a little bit. But I have a lunch to go to with my family. So one of my cousins, Blake, I'm one of 10 grandkids on my mum's side. And a few of my cousins, I mean, all of our cousins, we're all really close, but three of the boys I grew up with, just like so close. So they're like my older brothers and younger brother. So one of them is up here to visit this week with his girlfriend. So I cannot wait to see him and give him a cuddle. Sophie can't wait to see Uncle Blake and Auntie Rachel. So we're going to have some lunch with them. And Jay's is having a lunch break and meeting us as well for lunch, and so is my dad and my mum. So all having a big family lunch. So I'm just waiting for Soph to wake up, get her ready, get in the car, and go pretty much. Just realised we're gonna be late if she doesn't wake up soon. So I haven't had anything further to eat since we left the cafe. I'm starting to feel hungry now. I should have had like a morning tea or something so that I wasn't like going to pig out at lunch, which is probably what I would do if I didn't eat now. So I might make a little snack and I'll show you what I mean. So sorry about the kettle in the background, but I decided on some whole grain black pepper and sesame crackers, which are gluten free, preservative free, etc. Some pistachios that are salted. I love salted pistachios, they're like a weakness. And some baba ganoush dip, which is eggplant, yogurt, and tahini. Yum. Oh, and the kettle's boiling in the background because the place that we're going to for lunch, I know, doesn't have coconut milk, so I won't be able to have a tea or a coffee. I could have a herbal tea, but I don't usually like to when I'm out. So I'm just going to have a cup of tea, and then Sophie will hopefully wake up and we can go. Oh, look at that. Perfect timing. Don't be alarmed by the 30 degrees up at the top. It is not 30 degrees in her room. I just checked, like, so we are in the car off to lunch with the family. I had to wake up little Munchkie, didn't I? I had to wake you up, Bobby. She was sound asleep and I feel so guilty for waking her up, but we're going to be late, so I better get going. She's eating a rice rusk by the brand Baby Mum Mum. And they have like 3 flavors, but she only eats the vegetable one because it's the only one that has no additives. So again, another product where the brand, has certain flavors that do have additives and certain that don't. So always read the label, but these are amazing. You can get them in Coles and Woolies.
Know that I've been waiting for so long. You're all that I see. I can't stop this feeling. No, it's taking over me.
Up for an afternoon family swim with Dee and Sophie in her new swimmies. Cute. Go for a swim. I also didn't get to vlog my meal for lunch. As you would have seen, I showed you what I actually had on the menu, but it was a bit of a rushed lunch and we really wanted to catch up with our family, so I didn't actually get to show you what that was, but hopefully that was enough information for you. So we had a afternoon family swim and Ben and Jamie were there with Braxy, so it was really, really cute. Just about to make us some dinner, which I'll share with you. Another new recipe that I'm making. So this is the Jamie Oliver lemon pepper smash and chicken fillets. So super excited to try them, and they go with this recipe. Again, this is one of the ones that I found in the Woolies Fresh magazine that's free at Woolies. Just obviously uses products from there, but we go to Woolies, yeah. So it's perfect. And we had this one last night, which was the salmon tostadas, and they were so good. Like, one of the best meals I've definitely ever made. So yeah, so I'm gonna start cooking this now. And Sophie girl has had an early bath straight after the pool. Daddy's giving her some dinner. She is having spaghetti bolognese,
That's been all minced up. She loves it, don't you, Bubby? Yeah, I love Daddy Spagel. Also, I'm having these as a snack because I haven't had a snack this afternoon. They are the Veggie Deli Crisps Lentil, lightly salted. So, so delicious, and the ingredients are pretty good. I'm happy with that. So much better than eating potato chips, and they just help with that craving to have something salty. So I now have all of my veggies ready chopped. So I've got capsicum, zucchini, excuse me, carrot and snow peas. Then I've got the lemon chicken all chopped up, ready to go. And my little doggy in the background. And then I've got just some coconut oil. This brand of coconut oil is so, so good, and it's so easy to use. In a pan, just about to heat that up. And then some extra of the marinade sauce that the recipe told me to make, which is to sort of drizzle over the top right at the end. So, oh, and I also have the noodles ready to go. So these are Jaylen's golden Hokkien noodles that just need boiling water, and they soak for 4 to 5 minutes. And then these are the, what are they called? I'll get the packet out and show you, but they're sort of rice sort of noodles, but they are gluten-free, pretty much everything free, no preservatives, it's awesome. And they just need a minute in hot water. So this is the brand I've shared on my Insta stories before. It's by Slendia. I don't know if that's how you say it. Slender? Anyway. So it's their Calorie Clever product range, noodle style. So gluten-free, good fiber, pre-cooked. Comes with 2 servings in 1 packet. Where's the ingredients? There they are. Purified water and konjac flour. From what I've heard, I haven't done enough research into konjac yet, but from what I've heard, it is very, very good for you and quite rare. So it's a good thing to be able to have there. It's FODMAP friendly, vegan, gluten-free, amazing. And they're actually really yummy. Hi. Oi. You say it. Where's the lion? Can you find the lion? Look! What does the lion say? Yeah! Bubby, can you show me how you walk with your suitcase? Show me how you walk with your suitcase? No, no climbing in there. With your suitcase? Show me how you walk with your suitcase. Look, this. 1, 2, 3, go! It's a her new way of getting around the house, which is actually awesome because it's helping her walk. And she's not bending over, so it's like real walking. Is that it? Yeah. So this is the finished product. I wouldn't say I rate it, to be honest. I feel like it just tastes like lemon. Like, it's nice and I'd have it like as a salad at lunch or something, but I don't think it's dinner worthy.
Well, that's the end of the vlog part for you. I really hope you enjoyed it. I had so much fun filming it, but like I said, it ended up being such a busy day and we ended up being out for lunch with the family, so I didn't get to share the lunchtime recipes or ideas that I really wanted to share. And I have had a couple of mums ask me for things like that, sort of easy and healthy lunches that you can make that yourself and your little can eat. So I thought I would quickly come on and share them with you so that you still get that out of the video. So I've got a few things in my little goodie bag here to share with you what I usually have for lunches at home and hopefully inspire you. So my first easy lunch idea is soup. If you've been following me on Instagram or for a while, you'll know that for the last 7 weeks, I've been on a low FODMAP diet to try and find out what foods are making me sick, because I've had a lot of problems with that. So this is a FODMAP friendly, I don't know if you can see that, brand, which is amazing. But what I also love about it is there's no additives, no sugar. So this one's just a roasted pumpkin with a hint of sage. And I just have this either with a couple of rice cakes, and I dip the rice cakes into my soup, or I have it with gluten-free toast with a little bit of sometimes avocado or something like that spread on it. At the moment, I can't eat avocado, which is literally killing me. But yes, this is a really good option for lunch and super, super easy. Obviously, going into a hot sort of day, you probably don't feel like a soup. So usually sort of in the winter, autumn time, I'll have soup. And then spring and summer, I'll have a smoothie. So the second lunch option or lunch idea is rice cakes with either avocado, or I also like to do, which I know is a little bit naughty, but peanut butter with banana. So delicious. Hang on, I'm going to see. So the quinoa rice cakes I like the best. I love this brand as well. They're just plain, and then yeah, we add our toppings of choice. I also like putting Philly cheese with cherry tomatoes and sea salt. So good. I actually really miss that because I can't have Philly cheese at the moment. So another really good lunch option, which I absolutely love. I went through a season where I'm pretty sure I had these every single day for about a month, is rice paper rolls. They are so easy to make. Yes, they're a little bit like you do need to make them, so it is a bit time consuming compared to just, you know, leftovers or chucking a salad together or something. But I find once you're used to making them, they're so, so easy. And I just buy these ones from Coles or Woolies. I will actually be sharing a video with recipes and actually making the lunches, making dinners, breakfasts, smoothie recipes, snacks, things like that, where you'll actually see how I make mine. So yeah, I'll make sure I share that for you so that it makes more sense. Usually with these, I put in shredded chicken, which all I do is steam a chicken breast and then shred it up. Shredded iceberg lettuce, carrot, alfalfa, what else? Cherry tomatoes, avocado. I also make tuna ones. They're so versatile. You can pretty much put anything in there. So my second last idea isn't easy. Like, this is not an easy lunch, but it's a really delicious and a really nutritious one. And if you can do meal prepping and food prepping on like a Sunday or something for your week, this is definitely an easy option if you can do that, but it does require some cooking. And it is homemade sushi. So if you've been following Insta stories, you know I'm a little bit obsessed with seaweed at the moment. But homemade sushi is so, so delicious. And yes, it takes a bit of time, but it's so satisfying. I usually have it with tamari, which is a sort of a version of soya sauce, but a little bit better for you, gluten-free, things like that. So I usually have it with that. And you can never go past kewpie mayo. Like, if you're a mayo fan and you have not tried this mayo, like, stop the video now, go to Woolies, Coles, and buy yourself a bottle of this and just, like, chug that straight down, because I'm totally obsessed with it. I have it on pretty much everything. If you make salmon, like a, you know, steak of salmon cooked for dinner, I just slather this on my salmon with roast veggies, like, amazing. But anyway, with sushi, it is to die for. And then I just buy sushi rice. It just looks like this, and I buy it from the, you know, like, Mexican and multicultural food aisle at Coles or Woolies. I think you can use normal rice, but this just makes it that sort of cluggy, sticky sushi rice, and I do feel like it changes the flavour a lot, and it's a lot easier to make it with this because it sticks to the seaweed and rolls up really nice and things like that. So my favourite fillings to put in my sushi is definitely tuna with mayo. Another really yummy one is tuna mayo and spring onion chopped up and mushed together, you know, like, make a mix of it and then put it in your sushi. It's so, so good. Again, I can't have that at the moment, but anyway, chicken schnitzel with like shredded cabbage and mayo. All of my options have mayonnaise in it, but anyway, yeah, so lots and lots of options with sushi, and you can have just veggie ones. So I do cucumber, avocado. I nearly forgot one more. Now, this is brand new. I only bought it a day ago, but had it yesterday, had it today. delicious. Not for everyone, I am well aware, but some people might like it. And it is falafels. Now these falafels are from the farmers markets, so they're fresh, they're not frozen. These taste so amazing. They're gluten-free, vegan, got so many vegetables and herbs in them. So delicious. So I literally just heat these up in the oven, preferably. I put some of this, which is by the same same brand, I got it from the same stall, which is Labneh, which is like a soft yogurt cheese, like a Greek style Mediterranean. And all I do is put some of this on top of the falafels once they come out of the oven, chop them up and put them on top of a salad. Super, super healthy option and so easy. Yeah, that's about it from me, but I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please make sure you hit the subscribe button below, give us a big like, and I can't wait to see you in our next video. Bye.